Well, hello and greetings from Germany, and welcome back from the summer break. And we are very happy to have you all together with us today. Apparently, we're still sending from Berlin and from the internet, and we're still not entirely able to see each other around the world that we usually are. But we still are happy to have this opportunity to stay in touch with you. And I'm very thankful for everybody to join us. And also, I'm very happy to welcome our co-host again, our host, Dr. Christopher. Again, for those of you who don't know us or him, he's a good friend and also a partner from Quintessence. He's a dentist himself. He's in Mainz, Germany, in a... his own practice, and he's very keen on his education, and he's helps us to cater to all of you and to your needs of education and finds these great topics for you. So Chris, thank you very much for joining us, and I am very happy to see you again. We spent some times over the summer, so we're not out of touch that much, but this is also nice.
Yes, Christian, thank you very much. And thank you that Quintessence gives all of us the opportunity to join these webinars. And welcome back, dear colleagues. I hope you all had a great summer and recharge your batteries for the second half of this year. Also, welcome back to our regular after work Tuesday evening with a lectures and, of course, gin tonic. So I raise my glass and let's say a toast to the world of modern dentistry. I also hope you liked our new intro music. This one was Ben Fox with the name of Higher Love. And this song fits to Udo Plaster because his passion for quality and perfection is higher love in dentistry. For me, Udo Plaster is one of the most inventive, innovative dental technicians I know. And he also is one of my best buddies in dentistry. Udo is one of the leading minds, especially in digital dental technologies. The exciting thing about our collaboration is that purely from a functional side, we actually come from two different schools. My wife and me, we came from the Slavistic school from Vienna, and we're very deep into this, and Udo has developed a completely different approach for himself over many, many years. He has his own articulator, and you will see all the stuff he invented and he's working with. And now we managed to solve exciting and difficult cases together. And working with Udo is like a vacation for me. We are joking, we have fun with the patients, and we just like that we work together. And if we see the results of our work, we keep on smiling. And this is, I think, the essence of our work, that we are going on every day and having fun. So lean back, let yourself be carried away into the world of digital dentistry by Udo Plaster. Udo, please, the stage is yours.
Hello from Nuremberg to all, and thank you very much for the introducing. So I can finish now my presentation. Chris say everything, and it's not necessary to complete something, but prepare a small presentation. Maybe it's also too long, we'll see. But I want to show you a short overview for my daily work. So I think I could start now my presentation. Okay, it's...
No, you have to screen share.
Okay. Sorry. Yes,
don't worry.
You see, my experience is not the best. Now it's ready, or?
Perfect.
So, okay. So I want to show you my daily work and a digital workflow and how we transfer the data to the workplace. So
Udo, just real quick, just one thing I forgot to mention. If you do have questions for Udo and about the lecture, please use the Q&A tool or the F&A for the German-speaking participants, and we will try to collect them and answer them together with Udo after the presentation. Sorry, Udo.
No, no problem. So you could see now my workplace, and I don't know, in the middle, you see my table where I'm sitting, and I learn completely analog. So, and now when I compare how long I'm sitting more digital, I could say I'm working out 70% longer on the digital workplace. Not only on the workplace, analog and digital, also I'm working very intensive together with a patient. And for this situation, I have a patient room, and I'm working analog and also digital. But for me, it's very important to have a mirror on the wall, and everything what I'm doing with a patient together, I'm doing directly in the front from the mirror. Also on the right side, you could see my sitting place, and I have to introduce before the patient, before I begin to work together, to understand which wish the patients have and how is the history, for example. About all these things I will show you during my presentation. This chair, what you see in the middle, is now 25 years old. It was the first thing what I bought in my lab. And it was for me very important to have the contact permanently with the patient. And in the beginning, it was not so easy. Not all the dentists are open to send the patient to the laboratory. It was not so easy in the beginning, but after 10 years, and now I'm working 25 years, so I receive a lot of experience during this time, also in a collaboration with a patient, also with a dentist, and also now with the industry. So I want to show you 3 points: how we acquire the data, how is the process, and how is the treatment, and how we do this. Alone we can do this, we have to create a team, so like a teamwork. So and for me, every patient what I have, they are very different. So, and the important thing of everybody to understand and then to using this every day is how we begin and when we begin with the work. It's very important, one of the important things for me. So I show you an overview from my steps. I have 3 steps. In the beginning, on the left side, you could see collection of information. Where the wish from the patient is very important, dental history. After I analyze the facial and the models, and I could see how the patient is speaking, how is the vertical dimension, and also where is the starting point from the lower jaw. The name is MCP, the most comfortable mandibular position. So I receive from the practices 2 perfect impression or intraoral scans. It depends what we need or what is possible for the patient, and to collect the data or to capture analog and digital. Sometimes it's very important in front of to make a physical diagnostic to test or to define the vertical dimension, for example, to receive a perfect face scan and to cover the inside lips, or also a video. Sometimes a short video is very important. And after then, when we have the data, we go in digital to do this. On the right side, you see the scan software, and after the analyze software, I'm doing this in the modifier, and some steps we can realize completely now in modifier, but some steps in the modeling software. Another case is very similar. We define before the vertical dimension, if you have to change something. If not, you can working on the same starting point from the lower jaw, but the steps are all the same. It depends what we need. So we need solution and very flexible solution for different cases. On the left side in the corner, you see the situation with extremely bone compensation in the molar region and abrasion in the front, in the middle. We have missing teeth and baby teeth also, and the development, the vertical dimension, the molar region, it was not possible why the patient has in the 6-year-old molar baby milk teeth. So on the right side also, we are losing a lot of information. Upper and lower jaw is completely reduced. Or an accident case on the left side, in the middle, cancer, or completely a dentalus patient. So for all these patients, we need a solution to do this. So, and it's in a short time what we have now, it's not possible to explain everything. And now I want to explain a little bit from the knowledge from the plane system and why I want to explain you before what how important is the reference to transfer and also to for the positioning from the skull in on a workplace, analog or digital. So for me, when we have a patient, and it's very important to find the right place for inclination from the plane, and also to analyze the right and the left side. In this situation, what you see now is very easy. We put the plane in the right position, and after some 50, and the patient has the result. But to define the position is not so easy. It's depend also from the position from the lower jaw, or from the starting point from the lower jaw, where is the stable point to create a perfect occlusion and a perfect function also. So now, when we are working digital, we don't have now limits, so we can do this everything. So when we transfer with a bone wheel triangle, we use reference directly on the model. So it's the first thing. So when we have to transfer on the model, we could use this on the upper jaw and also on the lower jaw. And you connect the front tooth and molar or the condyle. You can do this now free. But what we receive in this moment from the right and the left side, we receive average. Why? We have only one plane to transfer. When you are using a Facebook, for example, you are using reference planes directly on the skull. And we have different, for example, the camper transfer option, or the camper, or a Frankfurt horizontal, but we need information for the occlusal plane. So we have different systems, and I'm working with this system, and also, and now our homework is, okay, when we try to produce a perfect denture, we have to organize the three dimensions, the occlusal view, the sagittal view, and the frontal view. And to find one with one reference plane for the three dimension, a good place is very, very hard. It's not so easy. So when you connect the right side and the left side, for example, from the condyle position, we receive an average from the vertical and also for the frontal and also from the sagittal view. So, and this is very, it's not so easy for the technician to find the right place for the plane on the workplace. Why? The patient doesn't have, the technician doesn't have the patient. The technician has only two models or two intraoral scans, but without information what's how it's looking around the situation. So the last 15 years, we spend a lot of time to transfer individual and to transfer the position without limits and without average. So we have to reference the true vertical and the true horizontal, to transfer the skull or the natural head position, to transfer the plane, and also to this position, the information. This is very important. Not only the position from the upper without information, we transfer also the information in the upright and head position and without exogenous influence. So we try to transfer directly. So the skull, you see here a natural skull, one-to-one, the true horizontal, and also from the sagittal view, the same procedure. So and in this moment, you have possibility to analyze the right and the left side from the skull. We could see here also the different inclination and the different growth from the right condyle and the left condyle, or the bone is very different. So, and we could position the upper and lower directly in the scan software, and we could organize all the DICOM data, or you can see this, or STS file, and we connect everything, could have the possibility to connect everything in this position. And our reference is the middle from the skull, and also the 6-year-old molar, and the cross point between the os zygomaticum and the 6-year-old molar. This bone is very important to find, to have the position from the 6-year-old molar. Why? All the muscle intention and the bite is in this region. Have to be very good and very stable to transfer the intention to the skull. And to this position, we have also different tools, for example, orthodontic tools to analyze the growth, for example, or also when we have a false denture or missing teeth or dentless teeth, patient, we could use the orthodontic tool for this situation. And also to this position, we could adjust or transfer directly a motion pattern from the of movement, or we could according the completely movement from the patient in the situation. So it's very different. You see the open, the close, and the patient is closing or is chewing is also very different what the patient has in the mouth in this moment. And when we are working virtual, we don't need an articulator. We could work directly with the situation from the patient. And also we could create a dynamic antagonist, what you see here in the lower jaw. And so when we transfer this from digital to analog, we can work in a, I don't know the name, clip clap directly in articulator. We don't need a movement. So in our teamwork, in my daily work, is one part is the dentist, one part is the technician. So we have to organize which system we have to transfer upper, and also which registration technique has the dentist or use the dentist in the praxis. Also the technician has to know this, how the registration is taken. I received the treatment planning and everything, the information about what is necessary for me. And also we could support the dentist and we could organize information what we need to create a dental solution or the prosthesis. So to analyze diagnostic, for example, what could be is a physical diagnostic, for example, it's for me one big part. I will explain this how I'm doing this, and also a digital wax up and position from the tooth directly in the skull, and how is the realization. So the first, the steps how I'm doing, see here, the first is the interview about the dental history and the wishes from the patient. We analyze the facial and also the model, and we could see how is the speech motor control. We could test this also maybe, for example, with a jig or with a physical setup or a mock-up to see if the idea or the position or this what the patient wants is possible to do. So to collect photos or face scans, to transfer with plane finder, and also the position from the larger to the skull, we define the middle, is one of the important thing, and also the vertical position and the horizontal position from the larger to the skull. This step I'm doing all together with a dentist, not by myself. So you see an overview from my work, for example, in the beginning, it's very important not to begin with a dental prosthesis and after without information. So we need information to transfer this directly on the right position. If not, we have to try in the work. One appointment, two appointments, three appointments, and what we produce in this moment, information for the situation. So it's better to understand what the patient needs and how is the wish from the patient, and to test this before, if it's possible or not, to stabilize this with a bite splint, for example, or mock-ups directly or removable or temporary provisional or prototype. Is I like the name prototype, not provisional. And after, when the patient uses this for short or long time, we could transfer directly in the definitive work. So and it's very easy. We have the possibility on this step to change something, but not with the definitive work. So plane finder, you see the landmarks. I explain later how and why. And to transfer in the scan software, the middle and the sagittal view, the plane. And for the vertical dimension, we have to organize this, which dimension is possible. And together with the stamion point and with the speech motor control, and also with the ankle of the jaw and the ala tragus, the inclination, we could see how a space we have in the molar region. And in better say, where's the 6 year old molar, the position. If the history, we see now in this case, the 6 year old molar has come a little bit down. We have a little bit bone compensation. And also the vertical dimension, we have to define the situation in the mouth from the patient, not later in our articulator. We can do this in articulator, but this is not in the mouth from the patient. So it's not so precise. The best is to do this directly. So, and then I explain the first step is splint, for example, or mock-up provisioner to test during the long time and after to transfer in the definitive work. So, and the physical and sensor, we have to test this, must be worked with a patient together. It's not possible to do this on a computer or to design something and to see now you have to adjust, to adapt also, or to compensate my idea, for example. So, and we have to test this before. So, and then to transfer to the finished work, this. Or in a case like this, it's an implant case. When we begin to use a face scan, only a face scan without good position from the lower, and also without a good support for the upper and lower lip, it's not necessary. So we need to do this before we take the face scan, for example, before we make a work like this. So, and also to see how is speech motor control. For example, in this case, you see the position on the left side from the implant, and I received this plan. So, and I told you, oh, I think it will be not working. So, and after then I working with the patient together, and you see where is the position from the tooth now. And it is this region, and we have to be very thin, and this position place is not possible to insert the implant. It is possible, but it's not possible to produce the perfect denture for the patient. So I'm changing the situation. You see on the left side, the old denture, what she has. It also is using for the plan, and on the right side is a new situation, also right side, you see your arch was too big, and also a false plane in the molar region. It doesn't work. So, and after we transfer this directly in work. So, and this is the final situation. So the steps, how we do this, right? This is a case here from Chris. I make this a little bit shorter, but I introduce here some videos to see, to show you how I'm working digital. This is the situation. He sent me this picture and I said, oh, it's not so easy to find a solution for this. We have to check something. So, and he told me all the tools have to remove. And the patient sent me also a good picture from the before. So my first step is to mark the landmarks, the osteogrammatic point, the zero line, and also the tragus and the ankle of the lower jaw on the left side and also on the right side also. So the patient has one implant, and after patient receive three, is the planning from Chris, and his insert. Maybe he could explain more about the situation. I am not a dentist, but I show you this picture. But the position looks very good, and we plan this. And for me, is after then to see when we remove the tooth, what is happening with the bone and also with the gingiva. So we are now in the digital room, plane finder, and also on the right side, you could see the three dimension. We have this permanently under control, the front view, the occlusal view, and the sagittal view. And for the technician, it's very easy to see all the three dimension permanently on the workplace. So the position from the upper, and you see here the video, the face scan, it is the anatomical overview from the skull. It's the front view and the 45 degrees scan and also 90 degrees. So, and we produce one scan. And I can working now with the landmarks directly. For example, the middle from the skull, we could see is depend from the growth. And you see also different how is the right side and the left side. The right side is a little bit brighter. And from the sagittal view, we have the device. Also what we have analog, we have this digital. You see they're adjusting from the natural head position, from the zero line. And also the 6-year-old molar, osteogrammatic bone. And when you reduce the opacity, you could see it's on the right position, the 6-year-old molar. And we have a very good control for the situation on this part. So we have the table, and we have how when we are working on only digitally, we can produce positional, and we could mill this and we could transfer the digital data to the analog. And this is one of the important steps. So I'm able now to transfer the upper jaw for the beginning, for example, or the upper jaw with the implants after implantation, all in the same position. So, and we could mounting this directly in the analog articulator to check the position, for example. So, and also we have to adjust the plane. And now we are working not only with one, we have here for the right side and from the left side, the individual plane. We measured this before, and you see also the degrees, how we define the situation. In this place. So I made the case a little bit shorter, but the first step is we produce a provisioner, and I send directly the provisioner, and Chris remove all the tooth, and we connect the provisioner with the implants. So this is the situation after the treatment. And the next step is, okay, how we could transfer the situation from the new gingiva to the old situation. And in this case, I need only a new scan or impression from the gingiva And this is on the same place where we're starting before. And you see here the situation, and we produce the first provision, what I produce, you see the old situation. And after we produce a bar, a metal bar, and we connect this together with the zirconia. So, and you see also the bite, and in the front, it was in her case very important to define the position from the tooth and also to have enough space for the construction. And in this case, it was possible to produce a bar. Sometimes it's not possible while the lower jaw is very near in the near from the papilla, and the space is not enough to produce this. But in her case, it was possible. So my milling, all the steps, everybody knows how it's working. I blocked inside with a little bit white material. It's like infiltration to a mask, the completely gray bar you see after the burn. So, and this is the work in the mouth. And we use a little bit gingiva, but not too much. It was not necessary to produce a big one. And also for this patient, it is a fixed denture. It was possible, it was also the wish from the patient before and after. Make it a little bit shorter also, and the arch, change the position. So another case, for example, here is a dentalist, also only planing, but it's very interesting to see how easy it is when you define the right place from the tooth. So upper and lower jaw, patient is coming with a new denture, and it was not so comfortable for her, and she decided to have some implants and to connect the implants with the situation. You see also the plane. Right and the left side. So I produce a bite option to transfer upper and lower jaw. And what you see here in the front is a little bit wax. It's only a support for the lip. So, and this device is in the mouth when we catch the face scan and the data completely. So all the next step, what I'm doing in modifier, I produce on the upper jaw, or I make a vacuum, you see on the right side for the upper jaw, and I scan this directly. So I have in this moment the upper with bite and one upper without bite. You see also the latragus. So, and also the zero position, and it's very precise. The transfer. Okay. So, and also the zero line. So when we have the table now. So, and after then, you see the position from the plane, from upper and lower jaw, and also the scan with the bite. It was very good also in the region, but not 100% precise. So, and after we have the possibility to put the teeth on the right position and to support the lip also. And I'm milling the tooth with completely, how you see, and I connect this with the vacuum. And after I'm using a little bit composite, or wax, if you wanted to make only a try-in. And it's very easy, very fast to make a diagnostic, for example, for the planning, for the implant planning, or to see if it's possible. So, and now in this moment, we are working directly with the patient. This is the physical diagnostic, what we do. Not only the bite, the second is how the dynamic from the lips and how is the speech motor control, everything we can test now in this moment. Oh, we could adjust everything. So I'm using a little bit composite to mask the vacuum to connect this to the tooth. it's only a layer blank. It's a little bit glazed, not more. That's the situation, and that's the situation now. And she is laughing. She was very happy on this day just to see. And we had only an appointment to try in, but we decided to leave her and to see. The situation was very good before and after, and only with a good transfer and with to organize the right place from the plane. A patient like this is also published in the implantology. And Chris sent me this picture, and I'm asking what's happening in this moment. And he told me after surgery, I forgot to make the pictures before. But okay, it's not so easy. And I'm happy not to be a dentist. So he inserted three screws also in the upper. And implants, and the lower jaw, it was an old denture, removable denture, and I receive only an impression from the upper and an impression from the lower jaw. And the impression was only with the three screws, and you see also I produce a vacuum and not more. The patient doesn't have in this moment a contact with the patient. So I'm using to transfer for this option, the bondrel triangle. So I'm using only one plane to transfer. And I'm milling the arch, and I connect the arch with vacuum. It looks like this. So in this moment, I'm ready for the physical diagnostic or to transfer the rest. So the patient visit in Nuremberg and we are working together. You see the vacuum in the mouth, it's the position is very good, and it's holding also very good, but the arch is not perfect. It's a little bit rotated to the skull, but without transfer, without reference, it's not possible to do this. Also, you could see the middle is not perfect, and also the plane on the left side and the arch is also too big. But to transfer, it's really working. So the first step is analog and digital to transfer the landmarks. And we mark the nasion, allatragus left and right, the spina, stomion point, and philtrum point, and also the tragus point. On the right and left and from the patient. From the sagittal view, you could see now the angle of the jaw and also the allotragus to the stomion point and the 6-year-old molar position, the region where the position is. And we're using the plane finder to transfer or only to transfer digitally. You can do this in two ways, analog, digital. By transfer in this case digital, but you see the prosthesis what the patient has is the vacuum with the tooth and a little bit wax. So, and this is the position, and now you could see the rotation also from upper, and also the plane is wrong. So now we have to define with the same position also the vertical dimension and the speech motor control, where is the best place. We're using for this step aqualizer. It's like a water pillow, and right on the left side is connected. So we could, a patient could relax, and we could see what's happening after 20 minutes or 25 minutes. The lower jaw is coming on the left side down and moving to the middle. And also before and after I was changing. So in this moment, I produced a face scan with this step. So, and this is why you could see now very good the distance. On the left side, see the old position or the first position without individual plane. And on the right side is with an individual plane and also with with a middle, and also with a diadem. You see on the right side, it doesn't have space, but in the front, we had have a lot of space. So, and during my work, you could see here now on the left side, one plane produce one, and after the mouse is very different. It's not the same what we see. So I corrected. I produce a new situation, and you see the difference between yellow and gray. And you could work now very precise. Why? We have now the three dimension directly on the workplace. We have the front view. On the left side, you see the different level from the face. Right side is a little bit brighter and higher, and also the occlusal view. You see how is the position from the front tooth and where is the bone, and also the sagittal view. You see also the dimension or the distance between the frenulum and between the stomium point. It's very big. We organize this in the software and with all the information that we have, and after we could create a provision. The first step is aperture, and we change a little bit on the right side. I sent this to CRISP like a protocol, and on the left side, we produce some tabletops to glue it directly in the mouth for the patient. So the patient has the three screws in the mouth. I produce three holes. Why? Chris could try in this before we change something. And if the passive fit is perfect, after he could feel the remove the implants and also to feel the holes with the composite directly. So, and the last implant, we have to connect this together during the definitive work. So, and you see here situation, but for this patient, the cleaning was not so easy in the beginning, and after was better. Sometimes it's better to decide before fix it or removal. But when the wish and the patient is fixed, we have to do our best. How is it working? So here's the situation in the mouth. And after I have all the information, how it's working, what is changing on the gingiva, and I'm using the same wax up or mock up for the situation. So, and I transfer that directly in ceramic. And here is the result after burn one and two. So the design from the zirconia. And you see the situation in the mouth. And this is the situation, I don't know, after 1 year or 1.5, I don't know, or 2 years, Chris did, maybe he could explain this, how old the picture is. So, and we decided not to produce a new work in the lower jaw. We changed a little bit the composite and adjust the surface. And we finalized the situation. Now you could see here now, the right and the left side, the plane is very, it's not legal. The right side is a little bit deeper and the left side is a little bit higher, past that to the lips, and to the dynamic is perfect. So, and also the steps on the patient before and after. I know we have a little bit of time. Yes, here's a case with fixed denture. I'm using on the same steps. So analysis, diagnostic, normalization. This is the situation from the patient. The first step is to collect the information. How, I explained you before, all the steps, dental history, analysis, model face, speech motor control, and the photos. So, and the problem was she received two new bridge in the molar region and with a false plane also, and she had a lot of pain in the neck and the molar, and yes, she has also a open bite and very, very reduced space in the molar region. and the speech motor control is doesn't work very well. She touched permanently the tooth in the molar. So you see this also in the photo, and she is smiling. The contact in the molar region on the left side is permanently, and also this is the side where she has pain. Landmarks. When you are doing this permanently, your eyes learn to see this directly, and you see if the patient, if it's possible to increase or not, or to stay on the same level or to reduce, like in this case. So, alatragus on the right side, alatragus on the left side, and you see the situation. Zygomatic bone, all the way line, looks very good also, a little bit support in the upper lip, but not too much. Plane on the right side and the left side. The right side is a little bit better, but the left side is not harmony. Open and close, and but you can see now when the patient is closing, the lower jaw is moving to the right side. And also the sternocleidus and masseter is changing the intention. And you, when she say E or A is the maximum speech distance, E is reduced. And when she say E, she touch on the left side. So, and when she say S, it's, you see, it's not possible to see S. She has to correct the skull forwards a little bit to reduce the distance in the front. And also the fricative F, V, and it's not possible to receive this. Intraoral photos. So, and now we transfer this directly in the software. I'm using face scans. You see the right side and the left side, the position. And for the vertical dimension is also to find out what is possible, what is not possible. And when the influence from the speech motor control doesn't work, it's not possible to receive a good bite. You have to reduce maybe sometimes on the some places and to fix the position. You see also the function when the patient moves forwards. She has a lot of problem in the molar region and also left and right lateral intrusion. Here is smile line. So, and for the position, you can see one is the sagittal view and one is the frontal view. And you could see also the rotation center from the posture and how it's connected with the skull. So when we begin with the front view, we could analyze here the position from the lower jaw, where is the middle, and how is the middle from the lower jaw to the skull. And you see here when the patient is closing, what is changing now in this moment. You see when she is closing, the tension from the muscle, and also in this region, the aesthetic for the smile line is not possible to produce this. It's possible, but it's not stable. But this, so this is starting point and the end position and end point. And from the sagittal view, you see when the patient is closing, the intention in the muscle. She rotated the skull forwards. You see here, very intensive, how it's changing. And also the problem in the neck, what she described as before in the analysis. So the first step is the dentist has to remove two tooth, and we had the position from the beginning. So we mounting the upper jaw in the same position, see here, and also the lower jaw, and we reduce a little bit the vertical dimension, and I produce a provisional for the first type as prototype, and she has the possibility to test and after to transfer this of ceramic. It's not so complicated. And see here the situation. So in this case, it's now, I think, 5 years old. And I have here, And after the lower jaw, after the upper jaw, we finished the lower jaw. And in this case, I receive intraoral scans. And I transfer directly this on the definitive verb. The situation, what you see now, this is after 5 years, before and after. So I think we have the first 45 minutes, or please, or I'm too fast. Oh, I hear you. Yeah, sorry.
No, no, whenever, I mean, you have all the time in the world. We love to listen to you.
Okay, perfect, perfect. So now I think it's a good time to have a break. For me, it's not only to speak only with my microphone here and with my screen. I think it's better to have some information from you.
Yeah, Udo, thank you very much so far. I think your material, your photos are extraordinarily good. And I think there are many ways to come to a good goal. And I see when I see these cases and some of them we did together, they are working good. But the question is for me, can you imagine that you can do this without the digital working? Because there are some technicians and dentists working in an analog way. And I know how it works with your system, but now it seems like it's only working in a digital work. Is that true, or can we also work this in an analog way? I know this is perhaps a little bit more comfortable to work digital. For me, for example, it's very good if you have a provisional or a prototype and it breaks, you can press a button and you get a second one. These are advantages in digital dentistry. And I have to confess, it was the first time with you I saw when you take the pictures with a face hunter of a patient and you can see the patient in three-dimensional ways, laughing, smiling with your digital planning. And it's really true. When I get a try in, most times the aesthetics is perfect. I've never had a problem. But is it possible to do that in an analog way?
Yes, this is the situation for me also. I'm working a lot during a long time only analog, and to define the molar region, it's not possible to do this only analog. You see more the front arch, for example. How is the front plane? How is the situation maybe in the first canine, the second canine? But in the molar region, it's very difficult to transfer individual for the right and the left side. This is one part for the position from the tooth in the skull. And the second part is only to do this analog without try-ins or with a physical diagnostic, what I explained before, it's not possible. You have to work with the patient together. The steps are the same, not completely the same. With a combination with a digital, I will be faster. But I need the right information in an analog room, so, or with a patient together. So the first to design something, yes, but the first design is very precise with the digital option. Only with the analog option, it's not possible. You could design something, and when you are using only photos, for example, you have a flat view, not a 3D view. And this is when I begin to work with a face hunter. I'm working now 8 years with the system. The first 2 years, the software was not so perfect. Best regards to Willy. But later it works more better, the situation. And I'm working also very intensive with Willy on the software. And after then, I learned to see new things and why with photo is not possible to see this. And you have only a short time with a patient when you try in, for example, to analyze or to see the 3D dimension from the skull. But with a face hunter, for example, or a digital, you see the three dimension permanently, and you have the control for the plane.
Okay, I really understand what you mean, and it's for everyone. It's very interesting. In 2 weeks, we have Florin Cofar from Denkov. And you know the smile design of Chris Coachman, and perhaps you have seen how he's Florin Cofar is doing it. But I think this is such a great opportunity to visualize what you could reach, which goal you can go. But this is not three-dimensional. And I think this is the big difference to the system you have. And there's one question from Fabiana Xavier, and she's asking how can we get access to this digital articulators. And we have to say our sponsor today is SecondSan. And I think they are very innovative in this field. And I think all this software, and even that you invented the articulator and the plane system, I think SecondSan has a big effort from you, or you together, that you work together. So how can the people like Fabiana get access to your virtual articulators?
Yes, she could. What I show you is modifies the software what I prefer. It's very individual, and you can do what you want with the software. This is and also we develop some steps who for the user is very important. You not all the technician has the experience like me. I have an experience on the analog part, and when I'm sitting directly in the front floor articulator like this, I'm working with my experience. So, and really is the develop from SecondSan also what the software or modifier software, and for the articulator, you can do with this articulator what you want. It's you doesn't have some limits. So, and the best way is to organize a short presentation, for example, from this articulator or for the software, and you understand more what you can do with this. But SecondSan, I think they have one of the best education center what you have. I think for a young technician to visit or to attend a course or to stay 4 weeks or 6 weeks now in this time is not so easy. But before was perfect to learn. When I was a young technician, when I had an option like this, it was maybe it's the best starting point to learn analog and digital.
Yeah, but there's a really critical question for some old guy like you. You learned how to make a wax up with your hands. Mm-hmm. You know how to make a gold inlay with your hand. Yes. And because you have this knowledge, you are able to use all the software. Do you think we get a problem in future that all the young technicians only learn the digital way and have no idea about the analog way? Or do you think it's not a problem because you will work only digital in future?
I think now you see we are using also often intraoral scans, and now not only you are using intraoral scans, everybody using intraoral scans, so the technician receive digital data. So, and in this moment, you have to work digital. So, and I think the digital room, it's the software is good, and you have also a wizard, and the software say now click there and click there. This is digital, but it's not real digital to working with a software. And without patient, only software, with software to produce a denture, a perfect denture, it's not individual. I think it's possible to produce a crown or a bridge or something like this, but not a big restoration, only digital. And also the intraoral scans and the combination between printed model, I see this is a big problem in the daily work. Is when someone told me, I'm using the printed model and my work is perfect. My answer for this situation is, I want to see this. And we try a lot what this is, intraoral scan or impression. I prefer to 80% impression and to 20% maybe to scan a provisioner or something like this is possible, or a small restoration. But you told me a gold inlay. To do this on a digital model, I think it's not possible with this precision what I learned.
Okay. So Udo, I think this is so nice. Would you like to go on for 20 more minutes and show some nice cases from you?
Yes, we have time. Yes. Okay.
Yeah, perfect. It would be very nice to see some more of you.
Okay.
You will have to share your screen again. There you go.
Oh, wait a minute. Sorry. Okay, this is a case. This is also an implant case. I think it's working. Oh, okay.
Yes.
So yes, perfectly.
See the situation from the patient. She is laughing and she shows us all the denture, what she has. And the first step is to the situation she has in the upper jaw or telescopic removal and denture, and in the lower jaw, three implants and three crowns also. So the steps is the same. On this case, we begin with impressions, and I receive an impression from the upper without denture and the impression from the upper with the denture. And I transfer this directly in the digital room. So I have two scans, and you see now the situation from the telescopic crowns are very thin, and she has a little bit problem with the situation. So the upper and also the position from the upper with the telescopic crowns. So the first step was to insert implants and to remove the tooth. So I visit Chris in Mainz, and I saw the first time the patient, and the patient told us, so my wish is I need a fixed denture. It's not removable. I had 25 years, I don't know how old the telescopic work is. I need a fixed denture. No, I say, okay, we will see if it's possible. And now you see why I'm using E or A, all the same steps. See, when the patient say E, the distance in the front is very reduced, and she need in this region more speech distance. Speech motor control show us that the arch was too small. And also in the molar region, we had contact on the right side, patient side, and on the left side in the molar region, it doesn't have contact. So, and also you see when the patient say E, we see the same, and when the patient say A, sometimes she's closing. And also when she say S, you see the distance is absolutely reduced. It's very, very thin. So also the problem in the front. So this is the color, yes, some pictures. So I'm beginning to show you the first step is with the landmarks. The osteogrammatic and alatragus points and the zero lines for the plane finder or for the face hunter. Here from the front view, and we see how different the right and the left side is from the situation. Well, one point is a little bit false on the left side, you see, but the neck point is the right one. And now we understand better when we see the ankle of the jaw and the alatragus on the right side and the alatragus on the left side, why she has this in the molar region, why is the dimension very reduced? When the point from the ankle of the jaw is near to the plane, or the distance between ankle of the jaw and alatragus point is short, the patient doesn't receive growth in this region. And also the upper lip doesn't support it with the denture what she has. We saw this also in the speech motor control. It's not perfect. And why the arch is too small in this situation. as we could see here, also the holdaway line, the contact point between the upper lip is doesn't exist. This is the second option to control this and to see what's wrong. And when the patient is closing, this next step is to transfer up and lower. When the patient here is closing, she press more in the front, and also the situation, the skull is moving backwards and change it. Also, when she is closing, the lower jaw is moving to the left side. Yes, we saw this before also. On the left side, she doesn't have contact. On the molar region, the implant crowns are a little bit too flat, and the plane was not perfect. So see, when she's closing also, the rotation, she's working completely not only with the lower jaw, she's working also with the skull and with the sternocleidus. So we fix the lower jaw to the upper in very reduced position with a little bit distance on the left side, but it was not possible to increase. We have also in this case to reduce the vertical dimension a little bit. So this was the same picture what you saw before. I transferred this in the digital room, and I produce also a vacuum on the upper with the implant, with the telescopic crowns, and to try in this situation and also to analyze the plane, the aesthetic, what is possible, and also to use this situation to insert the implants on the right place. So I'm milling this to produce a device like this, or a physical diagnostic option like this. It's, I think, now digital is very easy, and it's also very precise. We could reproduce this, or we could change something, and this I'm doing this with a milling machine, not by hand. So after we insert Chris insert the implants. So, and you see also the telescopic crowns are now in the mouth. This is not removed. So in the next step, we want to produce a provisional and to test if everything is okay, and after to remove the tooth and to adapt this to the provisional. In this case, I produce a tray and also a support for the implants to connect the implants in the mouth with composite. I think this is also the best way to collect the right place from the implants. I'm using this now for a long time with directly with intraoral scan. We try this also with different other cases directly with intraoral scan. It's working also, but when the distance between implant to implant is too big to match this on the gingiva, it's not so easy and it's not so precise. So you have to produce a small bar and to scan this directly. And here's the position in the mouth and connected with composite, occlusal. So now we have enough space around the bar for the material. So in this same impression what I receive, I produce a model and also with a gingiva directly. So and all the information what I had before, I produce a provisional. And also in the lower jaw to tabletops, and then the right side a little bit of wax up for the buccal side. So this is also milling directly with a composite. And the situation in the front, it was not so easy for me in this step. I saw maybe it's not possible to make a fixed tension. So we will see what is happening, what is changing. So at this time, the patient say, now I want to have a fixed tension. So this is the situation after remove on the same day. So after 6 months, patient was happy and we doesn't see something, how it looks in the region from the bone. But the support for the lip, it's not perfect. It's changing the upper lip. We need more support in this region. And the patient told us also she has some food in this region. It's not so good to clean. And now you could see why it is changing. The rest looks very good. And I feel this region directly in the praxis. And we try it again. And after 8 months, we decided, okay, it's not possible to make a fix it. And the patient accept this also. And we begin to produce definitive work. I receive a new new impression only for the gingiva. So I change this directly. It's very easy to do this. So I transfer the mouth situation directly in the model. So, and I have only to scan the gingiva, not more. And after I have a completely situation. So this is what we produce for the first step. We transfer the situation for the construction for the implant and also for the position for the implant to check this. Some peak cups and also a bite option for the heavy metal. You see the situation. I'm doing this together with Christian Hunker, is a friend of me, and I prepare this digital what he need, and after I receive the situation and what you see. So, and I prepare to test the position and also you see a prosthesis for the patient. After we glue it, it's directly the patient received this prosthesis. So it's always designed on the model, peak cups and the bar, the metal, and the bite option. To insert the situation to check the position and also on the same position after reinsert, we have the prosthesis. So. And in the front, I gave her a little bit support for the lip. It was also very important for her and for us also. And Chris tried in this and it was perfect. The transfer was perfect. So now in a case like this, to produce this digital, not by hand, is very easy to work. So the first step to insert implant and after the peak cap to glue it. This you can do this together with a bite option. It's very precise. So and so then the prosthesis now. So after I don't know 6 months or 4 months, we receive this situation, the gingiva situation. And I finalize the work, with composite, and individual gingiva. See here, and here's the difference between the first provisioner and the second one, or the definitive work, and also the support from the lip and the dynamic is working very good. And he's good laughing now, and you see all plane and the rest is in the right place. So this is the patient. She was very happy. Or is though, I think maybe the possibility to see her the next time when I visit. So this is before and after. So I think it's we have the time, Chris, or?
Yes, Udo, thank you very much. I think everybody could see that this system you invented for you is working. And I think there are many ways which lead to Rome. This is one of them. And I think you create beautiful cases and you did show that these also after 5 years or 6 years are still working. So it's just a congratulations from me to you that you invented this and everything is working so good. And I know that you are not only doing these big cases, you're doing everything on this. And this is really nice to see how this this digital process is working. I am still very much in this analog world, but you brought me to this digital world. The only thing I can do is do the scanning. The rest is your job. And I think this shows again that it's always a team between a dentist, the technician, and the patient. And it's not always the dentist who is doing just the great work. At the end, most of the times, the work is from the lab technician. This is how it works. And I think we are a little bit over the time now,
but yes.
It was a great evening. And I really have to say thank you for your time that you did this for me. We have to say thank you to Zirkonzahn to make this webinar possible. And I really would recommend everyone in 2 weeks that we meet again with a gin tonic on Tuesday evening. And we see Florin Cofar and Gustavo Giordani, which is also, I think, a mind-blowing lecture. And Udo, thank you very, very much for your time and for your work and your friendship.
I have one more question before we go. I'm sorry.
Oh, sorry.
I was watching Facebook as well, where we are also live, and there was one question, and I want to get rid of this, from Enrico Hautmann. Which material is your try-in? I think we can try to answer that question for him.
Okay, this is PMMA. Multi-layer, it's three colors, not more. I'm using different material, but with a multi-layer is really, you can do this very fast and very precise. And what you have to see, the material has to be very elastic, not too hard.
Perfect. Yeah. Thank you very much. Also for me, it was very interesting to watch. You know, it's as a lay person, I'm not a dentist, most of you know, and you know, I'm more on the patient side. I'm the one that sits in the chair, and it's always very interesting what's possible with the digital solutions. Although I am also a more of a Renaissance man for the hand, for the analog, but it's fantastic what you can do nowadays. So it's great. So I have to ask, who was the great clinician who did all that great?
Thank you very much.
Are you still there?
Sorry,
I think my internet connection is not very well. So I'm sorry. Yeah. So in any case, thank you very much, Udo. Thank you very much, Chris. It was fantastic to watch you guys. I shared the links to your educational courses and also to Zirkonzahn in the chat and also on Facebook for those of you who are interested. Thank you for taking the time and spending some time with us and having a gin and tonic for us and with us. So we drink to the evening. Are you still liquid there?
Yes, we are.
Perfect. Very good. So thank you very much. We see each other in 2 weeks. Chris already mentioned it with Florin Cofar and Dr. Giordani. And yes, stay safe, be well, and see you soon.
Best regards to all. Bye-bye.
There's one more question, how they can contact you. If you put in Udo Plaster Nuremberg into Google, you will find him.
I put the link on the chat, also on Facebook, okay. On the link to the website of Udo, so they should be able to contact you.
Everyone, enjoy your evening. It's still summer. Bye.
Bye, guys.